Paul told a great story, and we haven't had any of Phil's stories on Johnny Bower, but they were talking about Johnny Bower, and Paul says, well, he said, you know, I coached there for 3 years, and he said, the first Christmas party was so exciting. I had my family there with my children, my wife, and he said, I saw Johnny come on the ice with the Santa outfit on, and he had candy canes all over his pockets, and they're hanging out of his chest pockets. And so he said, he dropped a full pocketful. And he said, oh, the poor man, he was 90. Well, he wasn't 90 then. He was 85 anyway. He said, I'll go down and help him. He said, I go down, and he said, there's Johnny. He's standing straight up. He doesn't bend his knees. He just bends over and picks up every one of the candy canes without bending his knees. He said, I couldn't do that then. I can't do that now. And I couldn't do it as a kid. And this guy did it as an 85-year-old.
I was in Newfoundland with Phyllis Basito, Johnny Bower, and Eddie Shack, and I had the best time of my life with Johnny Bowers. And, you know, he had a very dry sense of humor, and he was a very kind man. Phil, did we not have one of the greatest times of our lives out there?
Oh, we had a great time. I love Johnny. I think it was 6 weeks before he passed, he and I were at a show together. And we just were shooting the breeze, just talking about the game and all that. And I says, hey, John, what do you think with all this goaltending equipment, how big it is and how light it is? He says, man, he says, I think I could have had a few more shouts if I had that stuff on. But you know what, Phil?
And you guys got to realize that goalie pads now, the ones that are coming out now, they're strapless. There's no more straps on the back.
You're kidding. How does it hold on?
There's no more heavy buckles. They're just a fucking little piece of Velcro, right? One strap that's where the back of your calf is. And the lace that you take and you pin the fucking pads to your skate. It's incredible.
Oh, I never knew that.
Yeah, Bowers. If you take a look at what Lundqvist is wearing, a lot of guys, there's only one big wide strap at the back of the calf, and then they have a small at the top where your thigh is, right? And then a little lace. And before, there was like fucking 900 fucking buckles to put on.
Yeah, they must be custom made or close to form fitting.
Well, they are form fitting, and it's exactly they've made the leg channel so deep and so precise, anatomically correct.
Yeah.
When you put this fucking pad, and it weighs nothing, it's nothing. It's because what they're using is they're using air and these incredible plastics that they have now, right?
Yeah.
And it's.
I was telling the story when we were talking with Johnny Bower, and I took license to use your story to me, Phil, about how well Bower and Sawchuk played in the Chicago series when the Leafs upset the number one team in Chicago.
Right.
And then they go to Montreal, and they did the same thing. I said, that was probably the best goaltending the Leafs ever had. And in chatting about Bower, and I said, if you want to ask somebody, I said, ask Phil Esposito. He'll tell you how good they were in that series. But the point that I was making of watching Bower the way he played and finding out that he was an assistant golf pro in Prince Albert, this guy had to be a pretty good athlete. And
think about this. Just to add some icing to the cake you're serving about Johnny Bower. When Johnny Bower was playing for the Toronto Maple Leafs, he was not in his prime. He had just turned 40.
No, that's right. He started there when he was 33, Frank, and that's another point about his athleticism.
And they kept him down in the minors. They brought him up when he was 40.
No, Frank. They signed him when he was 33.
No, but when he started playing... maybe I'm wrong, correct me. He was 40 when he was playing and he won the Stanley Cup.
Well, no, I'll tell you exactly. He came up in 58 at 33 and they won the Stanley Cup in 67. He was 33 and 9. He came up at
41. 42.
42 when he won the cup. Yep. You're right.
Yeah, that's he was so I apologize, but he was in his 40s when he won a Stanley Cup for Toronto.
The last one, he was in the 40s when he was when Phil had to watch him stop everything they fired at him in Chicago, because Chicago had a hell of a team that year. They were first.
But I'm
agreeing
with you that he was an incredible athlete, because in his 40s, in those days, Phil, a guy in his 40s was an old guy.
Well, we're not even sure he was 40, or he could have been 44. Could have been. I don't know whether anybody really knew his age until he passed.
Yeah,
but that's a good point. But he told me when we were in Newfoundland and we spent some time, and he had one Newfie screech there. He said he felt when he played for Toronto when they won the cup. Was it in 66 or 67 the last cup?
67.
That he felt better than when he was 20 years old.
Well, he sure looked it. He played goal better than he did. I don't know. You know, he was confined to Cleveland for 12 years, and he got 1 year up with New York, and then they wanted to bring Gump up because he was a young goalie, and that's the only chance he had. Imlach was the genius that got him. I mean, say what you want about Punch Imlach, but when I was a kid, Imlach was my hero. He was the guy that put that team together.